ତୁମେ ଟିକେ ଯିବ କି? ମୁଁ ଏଠି କହିବି ନାହିଁ, ଦେଖିବ ଏ ଶୁଣିବ କି?
ଜଷ୍ଟ ଆରମ୍ଭ ହେଲା ଘଣ୍ଟାଟେ। ଗୁଡ଼ ଇଭିନିଂ ଲେଡ଼ିଜ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଜେଣ୍ଟଲମେନ୍, ଟୁଡେ ଆଇ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ ସ୍ପିକ୍ ଅନ୍ ଇକ୍ୱାଲିଟି, ଡ୍ରିମ୍ ଇକ୍ୱାଲିଟି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫୋକସିଂ ମୋଷ୍ଟଲି ଓମେନ୍, ଓମେନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲର୍ଲି ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ହାଇଲାଇଟ୍ ବିକଜ 60 କ୍ରୋର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଓମେନ୍ ଇନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ is a major feature or salvation of women in this world, and their sufferings unspeakable in yester years. Let me speak. What is equality? Human to express capability free, upon choice and able to communicate whatever they want, they can communicate freely without any inhibition, without any restriction, without any surveillance, and without any ban. Yes, they may complain, they may be antagonized, they may be negative in mind, but thing is that community, society, ruler must tolerate. Of course, terrorism, or betrayal to the nation, those are not included. I am not talking. But thing is that on civic rights, we can express anything without any restriction. Then establish store, we can establish our information in books, in papers, in medias, everywhere. And also we can openly speak in public and store, we can store it also and destroy without any restriction. To see, to hear, to speak, to write, to work, to travel, to learn, to create, to think, to observe and make opinion without restriction. We have 2 ears, 2 eyes, 1 mouth and a tongue and a thought filling the skin and a mind to think and feet to walk and work, hands to work. All this we are having in our limb, in our mortal frame, we are free to use as we want to do it. But thing is that we are not allowed. That is called equality with respect of the community members. What they can do, we can also, we can see. What they see. What they hear, we can hear. What they speak, we can also speak on that. What they think, I should think in that way, or we people should think equally in the same way or a different way also. That is the thing. And right, we have hands. We can work differently. Whatever I want to work, I can work like that. There is no discrimination that nobody should in the community, that you should not do that, provided it is not crime. Right there. And second is that we can travel. Equal opportunity to travel to all places inside a nation. And particularly in the scenario of the world, over entire world without any restriction, provided authority has to permit with the intention. So that is the thing, is that to seek, hear, speak, write, walk, travel, learn, create, to think and observe. And also we can observe, we can see whatever we want to know, to observing. Some violence is there, I am a media man, I can go and visit. But thing is, the restrictions are always given. No, this is devouring the equality of the person as a citizen to view what is happening. So observation and make opinion without opinion. Like nowadays, what is happening? Equality is restricted over cyber media. I tweet something, it is a displeasure for many people. And in Facebook, I suffered myself that one person in Canada used offensive language against India and Indian Prime Minister, and I rebuked that person in the Facebook that how could you dare? The Prime Minister of a billion people and a nation of 1 billion people in such a obscene language in Facebook. And you know, he was, happens to be a respected person in Canada, and Facebook complained to the Facebook, and I was closed in the Facebook, not allowed to speak for 15 days. So this is a punishment to me. That means, even I cannot say to a person abusing a country or a prime minister openly in Facebook, if he complains, I am debarred to rebuke him. So this is not case of equality, the observation. So, and also dream equality is that there will be absolutely no discrimination on part of the people. Every person in the civil society has the equal right that of the others. By birth, a person inherits right. Whenever we take birth upon a country, we became a citizen of the country, and we acquire the right of the rest of the people. If I was born in India, and I automatically acquire the equal right of a billion people, absolutely same. No discrimination by the constitutional right. And what right I should exercise? To live, to study, to work, to settle at place, wherever I want to settle, I can settle without any discrimination demand, and of my own choice, and marries whomever I want to marry, that is whether he will be a Muslim, whether he is a Christian, whether he is a Hindu, whether of any caste, creed, culture. There is absolutely dilution of equality, but when two humans, two independent citizens want to marry with each other, there should not be any restriction of the marriage. And make a family without any discrimination. There should not be any restriction of marriage, settle and getting childs. People are there who are not allowed, who are so that thing happens. So automatically when we get born to a nation, automatically equal right of getting all these things to live, study, work, settle and class at a place of one choice and marry and creating family and having our own race. Of course, this is a ethics of civil society. Now, dream equality, many people talks many things. I am telling, this is the briefly what actually a common person should understand what is the dream equality. In a human society, civilized human society. Second thing is that in a poetic manner, I can say to you that see the sky, for the birds are flying, they are different species. Is there any description? Is there any country in the sky? The bird cannot fly beyond that. Is there any quarrel of birds between each other in the sky? Of course, you should not mean it that a hawk or an eagle is a prey. But once hunting is over, rest is peace and tranquility. And this is the morale of canvas of dream equality, where there will be no discrimination, total freedom of the earth being flying in the sky, no restriction of boundary, no wall, no differentiation, nothing. Exude yourself as your limb permits. Similarly, second moral I can give you, that ocean. See the ocean. Several species of fish are there. Thousand species of the fishes, the fish are there. But any restriction is there? Anybody is dare to move in the ocean from one place not to the other, provided his life safety is not that peace, then never go. But thing is there, any restriction is there? No. There is no, any boundary is there, any border is there, any rule is there? No. That is the meaning of, in our poetic way, the dream equality is just like we are a part of the nature. Human is an animal. Human is an earth being. And as other earth beings are having no restriction. You see, I am pointing out to you one thing, a virus, COVID. It came. Now you see it cross entire hundreds of the nation at lightning speed, mimicking the speed of the thought. You think that it is gone, and it crossed borders after borders of the nations with most fortified artillery, squadron of fighters, army people, missiles, everything. Could they check it? No. A microbe taught the humanity that you are creating your own wall. For us, there is no wall for us in the entire world. Earth, we can pervade everywhere without any restriction. You see the equality. Earth being has the natural right of dream equality. I conclude, what is actually the meaning of dream equality? Now, gender equality. You see, this is totally a hypocrisy. If you saw in the world, there are 4 or 5 billion people. Almost gender ratio is, but in India it is 48%, and in world take it 50% gross. And if we will take 48% or 50%, then out of 4 billion, 2 billion are women. And what if the equality is there, what 2 billion men are ruling this world, working in this world, enjoying in this world, establishing themselves in the world, ever women 2 billion people at par enjoying that? Absolutely not. There is a big discrepancy, and male from the birth enjoys most activities permitted with early age. A child will say, even if he is a male, I will drive a car. Will it allow? No, that is not the thing. But thing is that there are certain rules, and once the rule is observed, then male will be allowed almost everything they want from permitted age and as per the law of the land. Now, female never enjoy all activity freely, and rules devour. Rules devour male. In India, Hindu women cannot bear themselves. Bear means Western dress. I am not nude. But thing is that they cannot expose their body in the public. They'll be scolded, ridiculed. But when human main person can do that with a half pant, with a ganji or a trouser and a shirt, you can robe anywhere, nobody will tell you. But if a woman goes with briefs, you see, you will be quite in danger. Equality is not there. And also, in Muslims, also this parda pratha is there in the veil system. Without veil, you cannot travel. There are a lot of restrictions where male can travel in at anything, but veil is a must. And we are also, there is a wall between the male. Male can do something, but a female cannot do. What is their mentality? I don't want to traverse to that conflicting aspect. If veil is there, if parda is there, if sari is there with cover, okay, fine, you do. But thing is that you are differentiating a woman with a man. That is the thing. Female never enjoy all activity freely, and rules devour. What devour? In the dead of the night, I am a person, I go in the night, an evening work. There is nobody will tell except theory, crime situation. But if a woman will go, it will be inviting danger. Alone going anywhere, society has a bias attitude. And considering that woman moving alone in a lonely road in the night, that she is not good. Taken for granted. There must be some evil mind or criminal aspect. I will not tell explicitly, but thing is that obvious. They will definitely not decent lady. Even if some urgency, some lady is going outside, it will not be accepted by the people. Selection areas, some bars, some girls are permitted, but thing is that rest are not. That means there is a wall, within wall, some people's girls will be allowed to go where other people's girls are not permitted. I am a Brahmin. My women can visit to the temple at their pleasure, morning, evening, at any time. But I am a scheduled caste. Our women cannot be allowed to the temple. and few in Muslim world also, women's are not allowed. Yes, everything is there. Permission, I think, I were talking about equality when talking all these confusing things I am talking about. Very particular, I am thinking, not talking about religion. We are nowhere related to religion, but thing is that, in a sense, women behind the bar of the activity where male are allowed, and in also in certain cases certain women are allowed, but the rest of the women are not so. Mostly it happens in hazardous cases. Women are never accepted by the society to be engaged in work where the cases are hazardous, violence, war, intelligence, or travel alone, as I have discussed, or cremational rites. It's a very pity thing. Right of the parents, female engaged in a manual works. So, you see, normally in our society, even modern society, women are reluctantly allowed by force if it is done by case or court of law or anything, but otherwise, hazardous case, some poisonous area like a chemical plant or something where life, or atomic plant where radiations are there, and such type of things, or cleaning actually sewerage canal or something, they're very polluted, and carbon monoxide there, and so there. Never you can find actually women to be engaged in such work where this work is taken up by men. And also in case of a violence, street violence or city violence or country violence, mostly it is taken up by men. Never women are allowed to participate. Few are going and they get punished, suffering, wounded, hurt, like that. Because who are opposing this thing during the violence, one is fighting against the other, when the other people see that women are there, they rebuke. Why are you here? We are quarreling with each other, and you are where? And they put acid, they burn, otherwise lot of bombs and other things, they hurt them. Particularly, this girl is coming. And automatically, so violence, war, and intelligence also, mostly nowadays, of course, many women officers are there who are doing intelligence. But thing is that, rare case. This is their daredevil work, where life at any moment can go. And at that time, preference is for the male. And also, travel. You can travel even, you see, there is a notification in India for foreigners who are, they do not know, foreign is quite safe, but Delhi is not safe, Kolkata is not safe, and if you move alone in the dead of the night, being a female, you are inviting danger. So, whenever any foreigner are coming to the country in India, they are advised, don't go alone in solitary road, or where there will be no people and there may be violence, there may be kidnapping, there may be harm or injury to your body, or stealing may take place. Even people may also torture the lady in a very illegal manner. So that's why foreign females are advised go along with company. gender equality, normally we generally we face as this. Women's story exteriors. This is the heartening thing. I am telling you what happened in India. You will be surprised. A nation with 1,000 years of storage. What is the might of woman equality that we had learned in our childhood? When I tell about the biggest mythology in India, Ramayana, where 1 billion people believe it is a true story that happened 7,000 years ago in Ayodhya, there was a king and there was a war with a golden kingdom at Sri Lanka. They called demons. I don't believe he is a demon. He was a Brahmin king. His father was a Maharshi or Rishi and the mother was of Adivasi nature, and the person having a head equivalent to 10 heads. That means parallelly he can perform 10 things at the same time. That is Ravan. And Ayodhya king was Ravan. He was moving. Why I am talking about you a mythology? No, that is not my point. My point is that the entire story is kidnapping a queen to Sri Lanka. If there was any conflict between a prince, Ramachandra was a prince, and eldest son, and he was already established king, and there was a conflict. So whatever it may be, I am not narrating all these things. Should the king come directly by a plane, Puspak Vimana, at that time it was there, believed. This is what India wrote in a story. Years now it is happening. Plane is there. He moved directly into the hinterlands of India, into the deep forest where exiled, and kidnapped his wife, a married wife. It shows one thing, that to humiliate a woman, humiliate a man, they are telling to humiliate a woman is best thing. First. Second, how come you marry a married woman? That means is a woman is a commodity to enjoy. 1,000 and you see even today this kidnapping have happening. People lifting girls. Married, unmarried, young, teens, everything they desire, they kidnap. Second, why they take? They think even the women are treated like a commodity, as a toy. So when a human thinks another woman as a toy or a commodity, is there any equality? This is the mythology of Ramayana. 7,000 years that happened, we are reading, we are worshipping that, we are exactly doing the same thing. Never reformed ourselves. Equality exists in our society and also rampart. Very depressing thing in the society, it happens. Happener. So, my point is that let us see what Mahabharata has happened. You see, I am not talking you with religion or anything. I am talking about the status of a civilization how humans were living at 5,000 years ago. At that time, what you are calling as a Delhi, it was calling at 5,000 years ago as a Indraprastha. Yes, you deny or anything, but thing is, it was Indraprastha. And it was also the capital of Kuruj. And there was a kingdom. And where, in the court, what happened? The Mahabharata took place only because the prime scene was that a woman who was their brother's wife, their uncle's sons, five brothers are there, married to one woman, and one woman was disrobed in the court, injured. And where the rest of the people were silently mute and dumb and deaf. With respect of women. Are they equal at that time 5,000 years ago? Compared to men. Mahabharata depicts that. Is it not happening the same thing today? Yes, women are disrobed publicly and moved in road. It is happening. Of course, the course, law takes its own course, punish few people. But it is happening. The mindset is there. It exists here. And people never reform. We read Mahabharata. We worship Mahabharata. But we never reform ourselves. Women's inequality exists. There is a plenty of attitude. Many few people are seeing nowadays, you see. Please don't feel bad. I'm talking actually the plain truth. Truth bites. Obscene pictures or X pictures. Gloop cinemas. Now this is plentily available in mobile and other things that children can see also. What actually they seeing? Disrobing of a Draupadi. That Mahabharata, the sad story of a great battle where the entire clan of the Kuru were ruined and burned to ashes, only this contest of disrobing a woman. Now, we are having in your mobile, your internet, and also disrobing this thing. So, ever a reformation takes place on women's equality with that of men. And also, this is the mindset, people, unless if you one question how it will be happen, the equality will be established. You see, this is the oceanic aspect. It happens. It begins from the home. Home is a brick. If it is cleared at one family, character is built, sons were treated to respect ladies, there is so much family believed, hardened to behave ladies, at least one person is reformed. And this movement will communicate it world over, then entire world will be good. You cannot force anybody by laws. I will kill, I will hang, I will nothing. What happened in India? Everywhere, this rape and murder and everything is happening, you kill that person. But next day also another thing is happening. Reformation has to, equality has to be established by character building by the mother to his one kid and by the father to the son growing up, respect ladies. It is a hypothetical, but thing is that eons passed, but thing is that human never Ramayana's happen same story, Mahabharata happen same story, and also if you read Greek and Roman stories, everything is related women's sufferance and also all these things. Now this, what I am telling, the maladies, women of Esther years, number one is evil practice, aparda. I say each girl has a right to walk free without a veil. God has given a beauty. A deer is ever covered. A lion ever covered. A tiger ever covered. Why not a human female? Human female. Yes, for our decency we cover. We have a paint and set other things. But copies, God has given a face and so beautiful face, let the world see what is the harm. So that the veil. Evil practice, Satida. You know, you are from Bengal mostly, and you know Raja Ram Mohan Rai of the United Bengal. At that time, there was pre-independence era, there is one Bengal. And Bengal, there was a king, Raja Ram Mohan Rai. He abolished the system, the Hindu society, where there was a practice of teen marriage. Very child, 7-8 years, they get married to elderly people. Like, say, 30-40, like that. So, when what happens, that an old person dies, the young woman is only 14, 15 or 20. And widowhood is the curse of a human woman. White cloth, vegetarian food, no hair, sometimes hair is also, they cannot grow hair, and also no ornaments, they will sleep on the ground. Vegetarian food, they will tell, most of the fasting, like pitiable condition, heart-rending situation, the widowhood. Even these days also, most of the widow people are also observing this in Hindu society. Equality, they will laugh. What equality? We are female. The female is a tag of sufferance. After human sufferance, the tag is ladies. My point is that this woman or a poor, why you suffer here? You go along with your husband. So when the Hindus are lifted to the pyre and ignited, born to ashes. And what happens? This lady is forced to that and go and get born. That was a practice in 18th century. Most of the girls used to go diet only because their husband demised and they perished. This is a very a blemish on a Hindu society that Raja Ram Mohan Rai abolished that. Through conviction, convincing people that it is a very bad practice, please stop. And people stop it. Now it is not there, but child marriage is there. Dowry is there. Once you see your daughter is married to something, give 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs, if it is an engineer or doctor or something, a politician, then you give 100 crores, 10 crores, 5 crores, or big business inherited, like that. What not? Selling a daughter. But thing is that the society demands. there are punishment, there are laws, they are prohibiting this thing, but they, by who doing this thing, there are so many things are that by that way it happens. Dowry is not explicitly done because law does not permit it, but thing is that it goes on, and in most of the society. Then second is that cremation right. The eldest son will lead the pyre of the father, but the eldest daughter cannot. Even current days, it is also being observed that girls are divided to lead the pyre of the father in Hindu society. So this is a definitely block on the equality of women with that of the men. If a son is there, a daughter is there, son can lead the pair, but not the girl. So that is the thing. Cremation light. And inheritance. Inheritance means if the father's property is there, the son will inherit the property, not the daughter. Daughter got married to different family, but she cannot inherit the father's property. Nowadays the law is there in India that they can inherit, provide the demand, and also, but thing is there, lot of things happen in court of law, and practically people are not convinced. You know, why should a daughter should take the father's property? Is got married to a different family, and also let their enjoy or suffer or whatever it may be. The father may be a crorepati and the husband is maybe a poor person, but the daughter cannot enjoy part of the father's property after the demise of the father. No. But legally in India it is allowed. So, females are preferable in work where actually they are used manual works. I say manual works, I type. You feel domestic work, cooking, washing machine, washing clothes, and also cleaning homes. Teaching students, children, doing actually domestic work and all these manual works. But thing is that they are never allowed actually, general thing, housewives, they are never allowed actually the good things in the life like clubs, dancing, participating in functions and other things and all the things. You stay here. Within the house, I am going to attend the party, like that. The manual works are there. The women of Esther years, he will practice for the child marriage, dowry, confines the home after adolescence, blocked. No, you are not allowed, you are already adult. Melancholy widowhood, fasting, prayer, domestic work only, unhygienic delivery. And you see in India, there are a lot of death, unhygienic delivery. In villages, rural place also, and mortality of mother and a baby. This is a sad story, and a lot of people are dying because of the malnutrition, illiteracy. This is the sad stories of inequality of female because they have to bear the child, and when they bear, because of malnutrition and also lack of cleanliness, health, treatment, hospital. You see, normally a pregnant lady is carried by scooty, by auto, otherwise on soldier, miles within the rural village to the hospital where on road, they die. और इवन इफ दे सर्वाइव द चाइल्ड विल डाई और बोथ इफ दे सर्वाइव देयर विल बी सम डेफिशिएंसी द गर्ल सफर स्कूल ड्रॉप आउट इज देयर मेनी गर्ल्स 60% ऑफ द गर्ल हु आर गेटिंग फ्री एजुकेशन बट थिंग इज दैट लैक ऑफ मनी फॉर ड्रेस बुक फूड एंड अदर थिंग्स दे ड्रॉप आउट सिकनेस पुअर अपब्रिंगिंग आउट नंबर फ्यू गर्ल्स आर फॉर्चुनेट दैट यू सी ऑन टी वी गर्ल्स आर गोइंग टू स्कूल्स कॉलेज एंड अदर थिंग दे रिप्रेजेंट पैथेटिकली 15, 20, 30, 40% where rest of the 60% of the girl belongs to the rural sector, they don't enjoy. Nice schools you can see in Indian TVs, beautiful girls, beautiful dress, nice schools. This is not the general picture. If you visit to the rural center, villages, tribal places, you see, you will cry. They are reading on the below a tree, broken houses, no teacher, schools are locked because it is a girl school. Who cares? Go to the field and work or do the domestic work, help your mother. Nobody bothers. And adolescent, get married. Bear children. He is the one. We say lots of things in pen and paper. But thing is that basically the thing is that we have to change ourselves within, not in paper. Equality is a not a paper-wise enforcement, but it is a mental reformation or transformation of the society within. Then, girls suffer. Evil maladies in the society, I'll just discuss insecure female. A female is never secure in the family, society. You are a single woman. Go to Bombay city like a metro. Stay alone. After few days, enter colonial Marx is staying there alone. And what will happen to you? Nobody knows. Vultures are there. And how much you are powerful doesn't matter. Your security is a question. Insecure. In job, you are a woman, single woman, working in the office, are you secure? Boss are sometimes predict, colleagues misbehave, transit by bus, train, car, all things, you'll face hassles, insecurity stalks you. Forced to domestic labor. Rural girls are lifted en bloc and deported to metros where million people are there like Bombay and Delhi where crores of people are there. And there what happens? Man is working, house is empty, kids are there and being a domestic servant. But no pay. Their miserable situation of the girls there working as a maid, unthinkable. No food, no dress, no medicine in health. Forced to work. And lead like an animal in a cage. Many are caught, punished, but how many? it happens. Most of the girls are from the rural village are exported to the cities to forced labor. Domestic labor, export of a girl, child or youth to slavery in the dungeons of immoral activity like prostitute. It happens in big metros, and most of the girls are kidnapped or forced or bought even in rural village, paying to the parents, and girls are taken to this sort of ICS slavery. Equality, don't question about that. Mass recruitment of negligible income. Collection of kendu leaf. You see, in village sector I am telling about, kendu leaf, women go and travel entire day in the forest, collect kendu leaf. When they get, they hardly meager money. Throw away price, 5 rupees, 10 rupees, worth nothing. And also BD, preparing BD and cigarette like that, collection of kendu leaf, BD, matchbox, keeping matchbox, counting and keeping matchbox, and stitching. Some people are trained, some as nowadays girls are being, trained how to stitch this thing. They used to stitch, but thing is that salary is not that handsome. Mass stitching also, there are stitching and sewing, all these things are there. Marketing village products, many female are picked up and given some domestic products or village products like that, and you go and sell in the market. They rove in the town, hot summer, rain, cold, anything, with a basket and sell to the people. They build, sell and get some money. So this is the menial work actually. Get nothing as like a respected woman in the society. Beggary. The worst case is a beggary. Kidnap girls from the rural sector or in the city. Even it happens in the city. Kidnap. And force in another place and force her to beg. You think it is a story? No. Cruel humanity, we are talking about equality. People make a joke of the equality of humanity. And they kidnap and force them to beg. And wherever you see people are begging, they must be not destitutes. They must be kidnapped and a part of the crime racket, collecting money from people, showing actually very savvy, dirty look and dancing people on mercy pay, and this is collected, and lakhs of rupees are collected per day through these people. It's a crime. It happens. Molestation in family. The piteous thing is that in a modern world, Ramayana Mahabharata is happening in our own family. We are talking about everything. We are civilized people. But you will be shocked. Most of the girls are molested. What happens? The molester is part of the family or a relative or a friend or a person who is nearby in neighborhood knowing her rather than stranger. Remote is the stranger. Why? We are married. Nobody debates to marry. But still then, this hunger of lust. And hunger is lust. Why woman is treated as a commodity, a toy, rather than forget about equality. Rebirth never happen. Women never kidnap a person, enjoy this thing, it never happen. Women are very reserved, decent, humble, and also never immediately succumb to offense. Relatives and independent meeting frequently happens. Kidnapping to slave market or murder frequently unsuspecting young female, even export to overseas market conducted by criminal and racket. Exporting to Middle East and other things also, this is happening also in India. Milestones in Indian women. Now I brief my things. It's going to be 9. And I am telling you that the milestones in Indian women, I born in 1951. When I was 8 years old, a woman of Bengal, she was born in undivided Bengal. Maybe you should be proud of Bengal. Arati Shah, 1959, crossed English Channel swimming 16 hours at age of only 18 on her birthday. She was born in Kolkata in 1940. At that time, Bengal is undivided Bengal. She swim on her birthday at the age of 18 and the first woman to cross English Channel being an Indian lady. That is, shook the corner of India that a woman can swim English Channel, dividing the island from Europe. In sea. So that is the thing. Then milestones. Many sportsmen of India. Duti Chand, a great runner of my state Orissa, gold medalist. Hima Das of Assam is a runner, sprinter, and also got Olympic gold also. P.B. Sandhu, badminton player. Very famous. And Piyu Chitra, runner again. Mary Kom, Mizoram in the box. And also, he is a Padma Sri, Padma Bhushan, lost. Wild respect, sir, as a boxer. Saina Nehwal, the tremendous badminton player, world badminton player. Sania Mirza, our tennis player. Mithali Raj, cricket captain, and P.T. Usha again runner of Kerala state. And all these things are eminent personalities in sports field of Indian women. Female population growth, I give a glimpse of what is India. In 27 crores, women were there in India in 71. Now they have grown up to 66 crore out of 132 crores of India. Total population, where 48% of Indian population are females. They are 66 crores. Consider the population of Bangladesh. 66 crores of women in India. Total population of Bangladesh, Pakistan, and also several countries like Nepal, all these combined things, only women are in India. 66 crores. And now they have grown at a rate of 1.8. Then male literacy is 80%, where their literacy is 65.7%. Women's literacy 65%, where male literacy in average literacy in India is 80%. So equally of literacy, women are inferior compared to men because of the school dropout that I have already explained. And literacy growth, it is a heartening picture. There's good news. The last 3 years, 80% of the literacy growth. Literacy growth is 80% on the female side. There, more girls, the school dropout has been reduced and also more girls are there. Expertise female, agriculture, quite nowadays in modern India, girls are allowed and also leading in also most exclusively, significantly, and also they have done splendid job also in agriculture, medicine, economy, industry, science, aerospace, defense, research, politics, writer, thinker, engineering, bioengineering, space program, what not. Women are now the brighter aspect of India that in future coming, I predict, I may not be there. 70. So, but 2050, I think women will be the leader of this nation. Just like Indira Gandhi, again another person will come who will lead actually. They are doing actually excellent job. You know, in NASA, when Indian woman, a scientist, went to America, settled there, and in NASA, she was the instrumental person on landing of NASA's rover craft. In entire thing, she is coordinated in America itself, and American vice president. And there are two men, Indian women, who President of America has nominated as his representative in a United Nations to represent him. Women, sir, really doing marvelous work, and also in UM also, they are like economic panel also. And also few women, Indian women, are becoming judges even in US. So, agriculture, medicine, economy, industry, science, aerospace, defense, research, politics, writer, thinker, engineering, bioengineering, space program, everywhere, they are shining example. So, you have had lot of things of very depressing the aspect of women, but now you enjoy women are reviving, the booming, and because by their own thing, nobody supports them. They, just like I told you that Bengal, Arati sir has shown that I can cross English channel, similarly women are explaining by themselves. And it is a very heartening picture. This movement is going, is a female movement. Women's movement of liberation from bondage or chain. And we will be free and we will be dominant and we will also lead the nation, lead the world. They are doing, yes. Her Excellency, Bangladesh Prime Minister, is there leading a country. And also Indira Gandhi led the billion people in India. And also Kamala Harris, also the Vice President of US. And also New Zealand Prime Minister is also a woman. And there are several things like that. German Vice Chancellor is a woman. And like that it happens, so they can lead the nations and also have foresight to development of society by themselves. First Indian woman, I just hinted, Sania Mirza, the first tennis player in India. Sania Nehwal, the first badminton player who got a world award. Bachchendri Pal, who got to the Everest and thing. Kiran Bedi, the first IPS officer in India and also selected by United Nations as a UN woman police officer. Pratibha Patil, our ex-president of India, who happens to be the president of India. Mother Teresa, who is the first woman in India to get the Nobel Prize. She was a Catholic and served in Calcutta, and her ashram's mission, Sir, destitute children, all I have told you, she resurrected the life of the destitute and suffering and got Nobel Prize. Indira Gandhi is the first woman Prime Minister of India. Kalpana Chawla, the first woman pilot, space astronaut in West. Justice M. Fatima Bibi is the first Supreme Court justice in India. And Mary Kom is the first boxer winning gold medals in Olympic in India. Anna Malhotra is the first IAS officer, the bureaucrat of women bureaucrat of India. Hilary Kaur Deol, first pilot, Air Force pilot in India, the women Air Force pilot, Indian Air Force accepted women also. Nowadays, Navy also recruiting women people in also pilot, as pilot and also naval officers. Priya Jingham, army taken him the first woman officer in Indian Army. Now another hint is that a female corporate head, who are the corporate leading India in the corporate sector, thousands of crores. I'm not talking a joke. Example is Meeta Ambani in the IPL, Mumbai, it is 1,000 crores. Owner and partner of Reliance, the richest man in the world. Meeta Ambani, Reliance. Jia Modi, corporate law, aged partner is the law, legal service. And Kiran Mojumdar saw the Biocon, who is then they are giving all these things jab. Managing director Sunita Reddy, MD, Apollo Hospital Chain. India has the best hospital chain, Apollo, and Sunita Reddy is the managing director. Redu Sood Kannad, MD, Housing Development Finance Corporation. Entire country they are building houses. Suman Hamid, VC Cipla Medicine. Actually, these medicines are India is producing. That the vice chairman is actually Suman Hamid, a woman. And list is long. There are 50 in the Fortune list. There are crorepatis or the biggest corporate head in India. The leading is also is business side, being a woman, by their own merit. Nobody installed it. It is Meeta Ambani. Mumbai Indians, that IPL, she has constructed and established, and it is conquering in 5 times in IPL. And her type of inspiration, the Mumbai Indian is winning in Mumbai. And women at UN, few Indian women represented India at United Nations. Hansa Mehta, Lakshmi Menon, Begum Hamid Ali, Bijayalakshmi Pandit, the sister of Jawaharlal Nehru. All these people represented also India at United Nations also. And India contributed this year to UN $3 lakh for development of women. That is a function of the women UN at 2020, $3 lakh contributed for development of women worldwide. So India has a function of establishing equality of women at the international level also, this thing. So, gentlemen, I have already crossed 10 minutes extra, that I am expected to say 60 minutes. Thing is that, you see, equality is a question that poke our conscience. We are born out of what? Our mother. Whether a daughter, whether a son, a woman only shelters a human in the womb for 9 months. Her blood cell, her energy, her life source. We share, we grow long 9 months within her body and come out and say, when drop into the earth, we say that the woman that given her us back is inferior. This is the reality. This is the harsh reality. We never agree to that. We say, janma janani janma bhumishcha surgadapi gariyasi. Mother and motherland is far better than heaven. But we treat our mother. Go to Vrindavan. I conclude this story with a poking conscience of humanity. Go to Vrindavan, there will be Vidhava Ashram. Most of the ladies, where a husband is departed, sons have discarded, they are widows residing in Vrindavan, thousands in number, a shelter. If you ask, they don't have son. Yes, they are quite rich, affluent, with family, and claim themselves as learned. But they don't feel their mother is a mother. Janani janma janma humischa surgadapi gariyasi is the biggest joke in our mind. We are born on a land and we worship motherland as the mother. We treat the country, protect the nature, save the nature, save the caught our trees. Now they are saying preserve water, grow forest, other things, a lot of things. What happens? In Delhi, go to there, you cannot inhale. Motherhood, motherland, as a symbol of woman, are never respected by the human society, at least humanity. Even females also, if a woman is having a daughter also, daughter is not taking care of the mother. Mother is in ashram as a widow. If you ask her, what child? I got married and I am having a different house, what can I do? Mutant. This is happening. So depressed. The topic is not a very happy topic. My point is that I will conclude my talk to put a question to you. Please tell me in comment after. You know Shahjahan, our Mughal emperor in India? His wife was Mumtaz Begum. Mumtaz Begum gave birth to 14 children. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The queen is going on producing one after the other. After 13 and the 14, she perished. And knowing that her health is bad, she sacrificed her life that her husband should be happy. Her husband happy, equally loving her, build a Taj that the entire world is now seeing, that the most beautiful infrastructure where Mumtaz Begum sleeps. And her son Shahjahan was imprisoned in Agra Fort. And he allowed his son, please allow me to see Taj Mahal at the time of my death. I'll see. So if you go to Agra Fort, you can see Taj Mahal. And there Shahjahan was seeing his wife was sleeping nicely in Taj. Now I question, who is greater in love? मुमताज बेगम और सहजन एंड ताज इज ब्यूटिफुल फॉर हुम बिकॉज ऑफ मुमताज बेगम और बिकॉज ऑफ सहजन ऑफ हिज इमोर्टल लव टू हिज वाइफ और सहजन फॉर द सरेंडर एंड लव टू अवर हस्बैंड. सो आई कंक्लूड माई टॉक. आई लीव इट द क्वेश्चन. यू से हु इज मोर इक्वल इन लविंग देन द अदर फॉर व्हिच ताज शाइन्स सो ब्यूटिफुल. थैंक्स प्लीज. गुड नाइट प्लीज. I will not recite today my poem. Someday else I will take. It is almost more than 1 hour. I took it. It is quite big topic. There is no thing. Good night, gentlemen. Thanks very much. I thank the authority to allow me to talk so long. I cannot forget this opportunity. I express my gratitude and very much thankful for allowing me to dwell. But seldom I speak. Good night. Bye. Thanks, ladies and gentlemen. My respect and deep regard to all of you who listened for 1 hour my speech.